and tell you how thrilled we are to see you here, you and family members in town and out of town. It's just so wonderful to have this many in the sanctuary. Hint, hint. Don't usually have this many here. We're just thrilled to have you and welcome those who are watching it either live. Candles that we normally have, that we light going up and down the aisle. These are COVID candles. And you turn it on, there's a little switch under the bottom. My grandchildren have already found that. There's a switch under the bottom. If you don't mind, to turn that off when you leave, and there are baskets at both doors for you to put your candle back there. So good to see you here this evening. So thankful that you were here to celebrate our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ's birth with us. Please take a few moments to prepare your heart to worship God.
Thank you. Iowa City, they were extended a place to stay by a nameless innkeeper. Once again, God was with them, showing them hope, joy, peace, and love.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, thank you for your unspeakable gift, the gift of our Lord and Savior, born as a babe in a manger. Help us to give to others what you have given to us, hope, joy, peace, and love. In the name of Jesus the Christ child, we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
join me in the prayer for Christmas Eve. Let us pray. We are here, the servants of the Lord. Let it be with us according to God's word. Give us, O God, such a love and wonder that the shepherds of Magi and pilgrims unknown, we may come to adore the Holy Child, the promised King, and with gifts worship Him, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Thank you.
Scripture reading is taken tonight from the second chapter of Luke, the story of our Lord and Savior's birth. I invite you to listen to the word of God. And it came to pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And this taxing was first made when Cyrenius was governor of Syria. And all went to be taxed, everyone into his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, under the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass as the angels were gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told to them concerning the child. And all that heard it wondered at those things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart. And the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen as it was told to them. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in prayer again. Let the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, our rock, our strength, and our redeemer. Amen. Not long ago, I heard someone say, I hope you'll be home for Christmas this year, wherever you are. I hope you'll be home for Christmas this year, wherever you are. Well, I had to ponder that, home for Christmas, wherever you are. If you ask people, where did you grow up, or where did you live when you were a child, you get a variety of answers. Well, I grew up here. I grew up in Oklahoma. I grew up in Louisiana. You get a variety of answers. Where did you grow up? Where did you come from? Well, if you ask my husband, he would say, all over. Where did you grow up? Well, I grew up all over. That's the truth. His father was in the military, and they obviously moved a lot. He told me just today, he went to 4 high schools in 4 years. I always wondered what was wrong with him. They lived in Newfoundland one time. So he really did grow up all over. Where's home? Home is one of the most emotionally packed words in the English language. Home. That's because home means something different to everybody else. Some people love to go home. Some people dread going home. To some, home is the sanctuary. I don't know, I'm getting to where more and more I just want to be home. Home is that place that it makes you who you are. made us who we are, the home from which we came. And there are some who have no home. Barbara Brown Taylor, one of my favorite preachers, is pastoring in Atlanta, Georgia, and she tells about the time in the big downtown church, Atlanta, Georgia. There was a homeless guy that hung around a lot, his name was Russell, hung around the church a lot, and it wasn't uncommon for him to just walk up and talk to people out in the parking lot. That was kind of where he stayed. Late one day, she was going home, she walked out and got in the car, and he followed her all the way out to the car, stood there and talked and talked and talked, and she finally said, Russell, I just gotta go home now. And the minute she said it, she thought, I just sent the word home to a man who has no home. Until I pondered, I hope you're home wherever you are. It never occurred to me that on that first Christmas, not any of the people there were home. Nobody. Mary and Joseph had come from Nazareth to Bethlehem to be counted. The shepherds were in the field keeping watch over their flock by night, and even they weren't home. They were out in the fields. The wise men who show up later, they came from the east. We don't know where they came from, but it was a long trip. And even the angels left their heavenly home. Not a single character in the story was home. But that night and that day, they were closer to home than they had ever been in their lives. They were closer to home. I hope you're home this year, wherever you are. Christmas of 1986 found us, Greg and me, in El Paso, Texas. We were a long way from home. My father was going to have open heart surgery the day after Christmas, and so here we were on Christmas Day with my mother. My brother and sister had gone home to their homes because they still had little kids that were looking for Santa Claus. So here we were in El Paso, Texas, didn't know a single soul. We had Christmas lunch in a Denny's. Now that's an experience. So far away from home, just the three of us. But you know, something kept coming over us that We didn't feel alone, and we didn't feel like we were not home, because home is the people that you're with. Home is about who you're with, and we didn't feel so much like we weren't home. I hope you're home this year, wherever you are. Well, that's where we were. And we were home. And there's a reason for that. The Christ child, Emmanuel, God is with us, is with us wherever we are. And as long as he is with us wherever we are, then we are home. I'm glad you're home this year, wherever you are. Amen and amen. And now may the God of all hope and peace and joy and love grant you peace and joy and love on this night and forevermore.